Hello everybody, this is a polygraph, a machine for multiple writing by Edwin T. Ponting from 1865. We will see how it works and I will show how it was used. A polygraph is a duplicating device that produces one or many copies of a piece of writing at the same time with the creation of the original. It's built into a beautiful mahogany writing desk. It uses a pen connected to many other pens that move at the same time when you write the original copy. It was invented by Edwin T. Ponting. He was born in 1857, son of a pastry cook. He lived in South Woodford, near London, in England. And when he was 18 old, he invented this device in 1875. He was a pawnbroker assistant, so probably he invented this device to resolve one of his working problems. He had to write three identical tickets, one for the pawned object, a receipt for the depositor, and a record for the books. It was a long work and probably he got tired of doing this. He was probably inspired by an invention of John Isaac Hawkins from the beginning of 1800 that used the same system. But this one from Ponting, it's more specific for using in pawnbrokers. It used three nibs to write at the same time, and there was this pen to move all the three nibs at the same time. The pens are provided with a spring and are each mounted upon two short parallel arms to give a perpendicular movement to the pen. The mechanism is very beautiful with all these levers and mechanisms. The manual is on the cover of the drawer. There are many parts of the manual dot with ink, but in the end I came up with a transcription and I managed to understand the missing parts. This manual and also the other manuals I talk about in this channel is available for downloading in the link of the description of the video. The goal is to write the same words on two tickets and on an accounting book. Let's see how it works. The accounting book must be placed in the drawer in the under part of the machine. So you have to raise the cover and extract the drawer. There is a lever here blocking the frame, and now you can raise the frame. Now you place the accounting book on the writing plane. The page to be used should then be laid upon the writing plane, and the frame must be lowered down on the top of it. Using the milled wheel, you regulate the position of the book. You see? You are on the fourth line of the accounting book. The tickets are placed in the ticket box by sliding them in up to 10 at one time. There is a spring underneath to hold the tickets. After this, the ticket box is shifted over the column of the book. Then you take the pen. You see that this pen is in lower position. It's because this pen has to write on the book, while the other two write on the tickets. Then we write, let's say, a name here. You see all the pens write the same. And the pen on the right write on the book I placed before. It's very nice to see the mechanism moving in synchrony. Then I write a price here. It has been written the same on all parts of the ticket and on the accounting book. Isn't it wonderful? You take out the ticket. One part is for your accounting, the other is for the customer. And you move the ticket box on a new line of the accounting book. You regulate the position of the book with the milled wheel. And again, you write a name and the price. Of course, now it seems strange, but you should imagine an era where there isn't copiers and printers. But despite this, you need copies. As each ticket is written, you move the ticket box and the book until the whole page of the book is filled. I think it's a very beautiful device. It talked to us about a world where didn't exist copiers, digital printers, and to resolve the problems of the people, inventors had to use brass and wood, often without having any school qualification. It's a piece of our history. So we could say that this device could be considered a copier, a typewriter, and a printer. But actually is none of these. Isn't it fun? It's a all-in-one device, we would say nowadays. But this one is much more stylish, I think. If you like strange old devices, you could see this video about a typewriter designed to write on books. Have a nice day.